Hi there, my name's Alex and I'm the very proud owner of our beautiful Swan 54 COCO that my wife and myself picked up from the yard in Finland in September 2018, and we sailed her from Finland all the way back to New Zealand. We hadn't originally actually planned to sail COCO back to New Zealand. We were going to have her packed up and put on a container ship and sent back to the South Pacific and get the commissioning finished off here. But we made the decision to sail her home pretty much at the last moment. It was only 2 months before launch day we changed our plans. So you can imagine that the pressure of doing that to get a yacht ready to sail around the world when you've never done it before was pretty extraordinary. But we've never regretted the decision. So our adventure took us on a reasonably standard route from Finland to New Zealand. It took us about 14 months. We left Finland in September and we sailed down through the Baltic Sea, through the Kiel Canal, down through the English Channel, down the coast of Europe. We then sailed to the Canary Islands where we joined the Ark to cross the Atlantic, which was a great experience. We spent some time in the Caribbean, sailing around there. Then through the Panama Canal, then Galapagos, French Polynesia, the Cook Islands, Tonga, and then home to New Zealand. So we spent time in places like Barbuda, in Nevis, Dominica, where the people were incredibly warm and friendly. There was beautiful sailing. We loved the culture, the colour of the culture in the Caribbean. The other highlights for us would have been places like the Marquesas, again a place that's really tough to get to unless you're on a yacht. Amazing warm welcome by the locals, incredible culture, beautiful sailing, and then down through the Tuamotus as well. And we really enjoyed our time in some of the northern Cook Islands, places like Sawara, which is a really untouched, unvisited atoll in the middle of nowhere. And you know, incredible diving, amazing bird life. It really was a highlight for us. We also had some pretty tough days in the Tuamotu as well. It's beautiful and remote. A lot of it's not chartered, so there's a lot of very big coral bombies in the atolls, and you know, we did have a couple of moments where we nearly hit them. We had some pretty tough nights there. We had some big weather, being at anchor with 45 knots of wind and not a lot of shelter was a bit of an experience. And some of the entries and exits from the atolls, you've got to really get those right, and we got a couple wrong. It's quite hard to get good tide information over there, so we ended up going out of Whakarava Atoll with the tide wrong. We had wind against tide and ended up taking a bit of a hammering with about 2 metres of waves coming through the entrance of an atoll. But look, I've got to say one thing about this boat. You know, Coco's an awesome yacht. You know, she's strong, safe, reliable, incredibly enjoyable to sail with two people. She's a high performance blue water cruiser, and we've just really enjoyed our experience with her. They've been amazing. Like every time we've needed help, support, we've needed things sorted out, you know, Nautor have been incredible, and that for us is key. You know, if you're going to sail around the world, you can't just pick up a boat from a yard without getting that level of support. So we're forever grateful for them. They've been on the trip with us all the way and really helped us out. This coming winter, we're planning on sailing up to the Fiji Islands, and we want to get out to some of the more remote islands there, more untouched places. That's the sort of thing we like to do. So we're looking forward to that. And you know, we can't recommend the Swan 54 highly enough, and we can't recommend the support we've had from Nautor enough. So if you're looking at making this choice, you know, there are a lot of choices out there, but you know, we're really happy with what we've done. And my only advice would be go and buy a boat, go sailing around the world. You'll love the experience. We certainly did.